You may have heard about a company called Pipistrel. This is a Slovenian brand that operates in Slovenia and Italy, and its main business since 1989 has been developing and producing light aircraft. The most popular model is the Pipistrel Pantera, which is now available in almost all markets. One of the reasons why I focus on this brand is that it's dedicated to the zero-emission future, which is not that common for aircraft manufacturers. Pipistrel uses quite balanced engines for their one-motor aircraft models, and there are even several hybrid models under development. What's more, the company has announced electric versions of all its popular models, and there is one electric model of a light aircraft available for sale. This is the Pipistrel Velis Electro, and today I'm going to tell you about this piece of technology. First of all, this is actually a completely electrified, lightweight plane, so there is no internal combustion engine on board. It's based on one of the most popular training planes called Velis, so its main purpose is learning to fly, but whoever buys this machine will be free to decide how exactly they want to use it. This is the first electric plane in the world that managed to get the type certificate by EASA. Pipistrel says this is a very quiet plane that can change the way we use small aircraft. Also, the company underlines the minimal operational costs. One of the advantages of the electric engine and battery type of construction is that it has much fewer moving parts in it, and as the company claims, it may last about twice as long as that traditional aircraft engine. The electric motor produces only about 58 kilowatts of power. This is significantly less power than an average car engine can produce. Also, the Pipistrel Velis Electro has two independent battery packs with about 10 kilowatt hours of capacity each. So the total power capacity is just about 20 kilowatt hours, which is comparable to an average budget-friendly EV. One of the battery packs is located in the nose part of the aircraft, while the other is placed behind the cabin to redistribute the weight. Also, two separate batteries act as a safety feature. In case one battery fails, the second one can continue supporting the motor and avionics till the plane safely lands. The battery packs are also cooled with the help of a liquid cooling system. The empty weight of the aircraft with batteries is 428 kilograms. The payload is 172 kilos or 378 pounds. Considering it's a two-seater, the payload could be a little higher. However, weight limitation is still one of the main concerns when it comes to any electric airplane project or concept. The cruising speed is about 90 knots or 100 miles per hour or 160 kilometers per hour. This speed is achieved at 35 kilowatt power from the motor. The plane is designed to take off and land on asphalt or concrete runways as well as grass runways. You will need about 250 meters of runway to take off. The service ceiling is 12,000 feet. Now probably the most important thing is the range. Well, the range is not the marketing advantage for the airplane because the cruising speed is not perfect and the battery pack is pretty limited. So the company claims that the time range is an important factor to consider, and in this case they say it's 50 minutes plus the reserved time according to certification safety needs. The Pipistrel Velis Electro wasn't made to make A to B flights. This is a pilot training aircraft, so the flight time is important, but using simple math, we can predict that the range on one charge is about 90 miles or 150 kilometers. What's really amazing is that the energy consumption of such an aircraft is very similar to the energy consumption of an average EV. On average, electric cars consume 15 to 20 kilowatt hours of energy to drive 100 kilometers. The Pipistrel Velis Electro consumes about 13 kilowatt hours to fly 100 kilometers. Interestingly, the aircraft was already certified in a bunch of European countries in addition to the EASA certificate, and also in Mexico and the United Kingdom. The company has already started the certification process with the FAA, but it seems it will take a long time since certifying completely electric planes is something new and it requires new documentation to be prepared for tests. The price is not disclosed officially, but there are numerous leaks on the internet and we can presume that the MSRP is about 200,000 euros or $210,000, While the Pipistrel Velis Electro is certainly not the perfect electric plane, it sets the ground for the future of electric aircraft and shows that even with the tiny 20 kWh battery pack, you can fly for about an hour and get the same level of safety as in conventional single-engine light plane.